up. News 4's Sean Mazzarello has been at the coast. He's there in Mount Pleasant this morning. And I guess the issue now, Sean, is it going to get into the current, and is it going to be a problem for folks in South Carolina?
You know, Gordon, two very good questions. It all depends on if those tar balls found in Key West are actually from the BP oil spill, because that would give scientists some indication that the oil has entrained itself in the loop current. Now, that loop current is down at the end of Florida in between Key West. Loop current dumps into the Gulf Stream, which comes all the way up the Atlantic here to South Carolina. So scientists I spoke with at the College of Charleston yesterday say this could impact South Carolina's Gulf Stream. That's more than 15 miles offshore. That's why they don't feel it would have a huge impact on South Carolina's shoreline. Now, North Carolina's shoreline, the Outer Banks, Cape Hatteras, that is closer to the Gulf Stream. But back to South Carolina's coastline, listen to what this oceanographer says about the impact it would have on our shorelines.
Most of the effects will be offshore. The onshore effects here in South Carolina, you know, it seems like it shouldn't be that great unless we get northerly winds that would transport that oil from the Gulf Stream towards the coast. But that's what it would take.
You know, then the question is how much oil would actually make it into. That's something that they just don't know right now, and they won't know at this point, because even if the oil did get into the Gulf Stream, the theory is by these scientists is that it would be somewhat diluted because it's so far away from the actual oil spill. So a lot depends on what the currents are doing, which directly is directly affected by the wind as well. So there's a lot of what ifs right now, but they are saying if it does, oil does arrive in our along the South Carolina coastline, it would be about a month from now. I'm Sean Mazzarella, WYFF News 4 Today, live at Patriots Point in Mount Pleasant.
All right, Sean, thank you for continuing coverage of the oil spill. Stay with News 4. Sean will bring us more live reports throughout this newscast. And you can tune into News 4 Today every morning. We're going to keep giving you every day updates on the situation in the Gulf.